Good morning and welcome to Metallica High School as we're here for the CQL 2022 Super Bowl as we're on to the senior matchup featuring the Evergreen Eagles and the Dinwiddie Generals. Sean Hicks here providing you live commentary. Also, today's game is being recorded by the RVA Sports Production Team. Much love and thanks to them as always. And if you missed earlier game's matchup, for the minor Super Bowl, the Jacobs Jaguars defeated the Dinwiddie Generals 8-7 as they get their first Super Bowl victory in association history. And as for the junior matchup, the Spring Run Huskies were victorious over the Hopkins Bobcats 14-0. Now on to the senior matchup. Evergreen is set to kick it off to Dinwiddie to get the game underway. And it's a squib kick in the middle, ball still hot, and it's picked up at the 45. It is Javion Hill Jackson, the returner, and it's a short return as he's brought down right at midfield.
Bring them out, bring them out, bring them out, bring them out. It's hard to yell when the bat rails in your mouth. Bring them out, bring them out, bring them out, bring them out, bring them out.
So first down and 10, coming up for the Generals, ball at midfield. Kayvon Wiggins under center. Handoff goes to McDevlin Manson. Manson to the outside, breaking tackles. And he's still on his feet. Touchdown, Generals. Oh, and wasting no time. 50 yards. Touchdown run off the jump. Well, so that's a good way to start for the Generals as they strike first. And the extra point is coming up. And the extra point is no good. So 9-12 left in the first quarter. The score, Generals 6 and the Eagles 0. Generals line up to kick it off. It's a squib kick. Right in the middle, recovered at the 45-yard line. Nice job there by number 11, Aiden Parsley, to come up with it. So the Eagles going off this for the first time today. Let's see how they respond on this drive after the Generals touchdown. First and 10. First down, run to the outside. And that handoff was to Anthony Carter. And Carter is wrestled down to the ground. Nice solid run there as that tackle was made by number 28. That's Tyler Peterson. That brings up second down and 3. All right, so check that. The last tackle was by Rodrell Golson. You're welcome. Second down and 3. Ball at the 48. Hand off to the big fella up the middle. Zeke powers his way forward for a pickup of about a yard or two. That was Camden Wasaki with the carry there. Brings up third down and 1.
Come on, Zeke. Come on, Zeke.
So that was Anthony Carter with the carry. He's going to be short there as that tackle was made by number 1. That's McDevlin Manson. So a timeout is called on the field by Evergreen. That will be their first charge. Timeout.
Make a play, cut. Shoot the gap, make a play, cut.
After the Evergreen timeout, it's fourth down and a yard. Hand off up the middle, that's the first down for Evergreen. Wasaki, the ball carrier, as he was brought down to the ground by number 55, that's Austin Wells. So Evergreen keeps the drive going. First and 10, ball at the 43. And the screen pass is caught That's to the outside. That's to Rasheed Davis. And Davis sprints outside. Nice solid gain there. So that brings up second down and three.
Come on, D.
Hewitt drops back to pass. Oh, he's hit while he's throwing. He throws it deep, and it's caught! Oh, it's Rasheed Davis! Touchdown, Evergreen! Oh, what a great throw, and a great catch by Davis. And Evergreen Eagles tied up at six. Extra point coming up. So Evergreen lines up with a two-point conversion, but kicking it between the uprights. There's a snap, the hold, the kick is blocked. Extra point, no good. So 5:34 left in the first quarter. We got ourselves a game here. It's tied up at six. Nice kickoff there by Green, and it's picked up at the 10. And a good return, oh, he's got open room! That's Quentin Hawkins Jr. He's got one man to beat over his tail, but he has enough, he does! Finley enters right back, 90-yard kickoff return! And the general fans love what they just saw. And Dinwiddie got the answer they need with the exclamation point. 90-yard kickoff return to the house. Generals reclaim the lead. Extra point coming up. All right, so Dinwiddie lines up to kick for the two-point conversion. And a box snap, extra point is no good. So 5:15 left in the first quarter. The score, Dinwiddie 12, Evergreen 6. Also, it's a friendly reminder that the concession stand is still open. So if you're hungry or thirsty, go check it out. Also, CQL is selling merchandise. They're selling short sleeve t-shirts, long sleeve t-shirts, as well as CQL jerseys if you want to rock the apparel. Also, the Matoaka Holiday Market is currently going on as well from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. with homemade gifts, rep from your vendors, raffle bake sale, and caroling. You can come out, do a little shopping, and enjoy some quality times with the ones that you love. All the proceeds will go to the Matoaka Chorus Department. So Derek is Nelson set to kick it off for Dinwiddie. Hey, And a high short kick. Field it at the 29. That's Davis with the return.
Yeah, Mac. I see you, Mac. Who are you hit, boy?
And bring up first down and 10 for the Eagles. First down and 10 for Evergreen. Ball at the 40. Screen pass, it's caught. Oh, that's tackle right in the backfield. Nowhere to go on that play. Good tackle there by Kayvon Wiggins. So that's a loss of about 3 yards, second and 13. Handoff up the middle, that's to Carter. And Carter is wrestled forward. He's met by a whole bunch of generals on that play. Leading the charge on that was number 52, that's Gabriel Randall. So that's a pickup of 3, 3rd and 10.
Let's go, D.
Hewitt hands off to Carter. Once again, it gets through the hole. Carter still chopping his feet. Oh, the ball does come out at the end. And it will be... Boston will officials say. They said the Carter's knee was down before the football came out. So Evergreen catches a break there, and it brings up 4th down and 1. Down and 1 coming up for the Eagles. Handoff to Carter. Carter shoots his way forward, and he should have enough for the first down, and indeed he does. Keep the chains moving for the Eagles. Keeps the drive going. 1st and 10, ball at the Dinwiddie 49. Hewitt hands off to Carter. Carter continuing to run forward and putting general defenders on his back. And leading the charge on that tackle is number 3, that's Jamion Hill Jackson. So Carter's run, good for an Evergreen first down. At the 39, 1st and 10. Hewitt gives it to Wasaki up the middle, and he's met by a wall of generals on that play. And nice tackle there. Austin Wells there on the stop. Also there was number 76. That's Miles Bracey. So a pickup of a yard, 2nd down and 9. Under 2 minutes left in the first quarter.
Come on, D. Come on, D. Get off the field. Let's go. They're controlling the clock.
Tosses it to Carter. Carter in trouble. He spins his way forward. And a nice tackle there by McDevlin Manson. Alright, so he was able to get some positive yards. Not much though. So it brings up third down and 7. Third down, Wasaki with the carry up the middle. And he bullies his way forward for a short gain once again. It is Austin Wells once again making the tackle. Looks like they're going to run the clock out and take it to the end of the first quarter, which has been an entertaining one, with the Dinwiddie Generals currently leading over the Everett. Start the second quarter, fourth down and 2 coming up for the Eagles. Wasaki does a jump pass. Oh, that's a great play there. Right off the college playbook there. As he gets it to his receiver, number 87, that's Robbie Scheiss. All right, so the jump pass, it works on that play and it keeps the Eagles drive going once again. They're 2 for 2 on fourth down conversions on this drive. Alright, so first down and 10 for the Eagles, ball at the 32. Waxaki with the carry, and it's taking a bunch of generals to get him down, but he did get him down. Good tag team tackle there by Jamion Hill Jackson, along with number 73, that's Connor Barron. No gain on that last play, 2nd and 10. Hewitt hands off to Carter with the hesitation, and he is stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Again, a bunch of generals there on the stop. Right, and leading the charge on that tackle was Quinton Hawkins Jr. Alright, so it was actually a loss of a yard, 3rd and 11. Hewitt drops back to pass, he feels the heat, and it's a screen pass to the Goodfella. That's why Sikki. Rumbling, stumbling, bowling, first down, Evergreen. Oh man, he's fun to watch. That was a nice run there, nice play execution. And the Eagles get inside the red zone. It's going to be a first down and goal opportunity coming up.
What are you doing? Where are the linebackers at? Where are the linebackers at? back is that?
Handoff goes to Carter. And Carter stood up at the line of scrimmage. Not much happening there. Again, a bunch of generals there on the stop. And a tag team tackle there by Gabriel Randall and Austin Wells. And a timeout called on the field by Evergreen. That's their second charge timeout with 7:02 left in the second quarter. Resume play after the Evergreen timeout. They have one left. Dinwiddie still has all three. First down and goal, or second and goal, actually. Hewitt drops back to pass. He throws one way out the end zone. That one falls incomplete. So that brings up third down and goal, ball at the 10. Hewitt goes to his left. He's going to improvise and call his own number, and not much happening there. The Generals sniff that one out, and he's brought down to the ground at the line of scrimmage. So that brings up fourth down and goal. And a timeout called on the field by Evergreen. And that's their third and final charge. Timeout, 6:08 left in the second quarter. And screen pass, Hewitt to Davis. And Davis is surrounded and dropped to the ground. He will be well short of the first down marker. Good job there by the Dinwiddie defense. He put the foot down and makes a defensive stand. So the Generals back on offense. It'll be first down and 10. First down and 10 for Dinwiddie. And off to the left side. That's open field. That's to Nelson. Nelson spinning. And then he was shoved out of bounds by Rasheed Davis. It's a touchdown saving play there. And Nelson just shot out of a cannon on that play. And it gets Dinwiddie. Some good plays, but this one is going to be coming back. Holding called against the Generals. Alright, so that's going to back them up 10 yards and we'll replay first down. Alright, so that'll back them up half the distance. So it's first and 15, ball at the 5. Wiggins with the handoff goes to Manson. And Manson is dropped and spun and thrown to the ground. And it's Camden Wasaki there on the tackle. Brings up second down. Second down and 15. Wiggins sends Manson in motion. Wiggins drops back. He throws it up, and it is incomplete. The pass was a little bit behind his intended receiver, Hawkins Jr. Good secondary play there by Anthony Carter. Brings up third down. And it's going to be a little screen pass, and it's to Nelson. Oh, Nelson with Green in front of him. And Nelson is gone. 95-yard touchdown. No flags. Oh, when Dinwiddie Spears gets this big home run, please. And it's showing they did it again there. Nelson, 95 yards to the house as they extend their lead. Extra point coming up. So Nelson, after scoring that touchdown, probably a little exhausted now, will line up to kick it for the two-point conversion. Kick is up, and the kick is no good. So the score with 3:36 left in the second quarter, the Generals 18 and Eagles at 6. Thank you. All right, so Dinwiddie is set to kick this one off. As Nelson will kick it off, solid low line driver, fielded at the 26th by Rasheed Davis. And Davis will run out of bounds, nice return there, right across the 45. All right, so Evergreen goes back on offense. They're down by 12. Let's see what happens on this drive. It'll be first down and 10. Hewitt drops back to pass. He wants it all. He's going to throw it deep, and it is incomplete. The ball looked like it was nearly picked off, but the ball went out of bounds. This brings up second down and 10. Second down and 10, ball still at the 45. Hewitt hands off to Anthony Carter. And Carter breaks two arm tackles, hits the spin button, and advances forward for a pickup of about 3 to 4 yards. And a good tackle there made by Connor Barron. Brings up third down and 7. Third down, Hewitt hands off to Carter once again. Carter having success on the ground, and he surges forward close to the first down marker. A bunch of generals storm in to make the stop. And Carter's hard efforts is good for an Evergreen first down. All right, so 90 seconds left until halftime. Evergreen marching down the field into Dinwiddie territory at the 45. First and 10, Hewitt again. It's Carter with the carry. And again, a bunch of generals there on the stop. Hill Jackson there along with Gabriel Randall. So under a minute left, brings up second down and 4. So again, Evergreen going up tempo, they're out of timeouts. Handoff to Carter. Carter in trouble. Oh, the ball comes out and is picked up by Dinwiddie. And Dinwiddie has the ball. Allen Lindsay down, the official said he was down. So nice return there by even Parham with the return. After the forced fumble on the play, nice job there by Dinwiddie. And they go back on offense with a short field in front of them, all three timeouts in hand. Will be first down and 10. And a timeout is called on the field by the Generals. That'll be their first charge, timeout.
Take a look. I'm a hard hitter. I'm a hard hitter.
All right, we'll resume play after the Dinwiddie timeout. It's 1st and 10, ball at the 34. Dinwiddie's coming with the same look. Wiggins is going to improvise, call his own number, breaks a tackle, and he's brought down to the ground. And a timeout is called on the field by Dinwiddie. That's their second charge. Timeout, 14 seconds left. Action, 2nd and 2. Wiggins in the pocket, throws a strike, it's caught. Hawkins, Jr. And it's a touchdown, but there's a penalty flag back at the 30. And this one is coming back, holding, called against the Generals. All right, so 2nd down and long coming up for Dinwiddie. This will more likely be the final play of the half. Wiggins steps up. Oh, he's hit while he's thrown. Penalty flag again thrown on the field. And the pass is intercepted by the Eagles. But again, there is a penalty flag in the Dinwiddie backfield. All right, so the penalty was called against Dinwiddie. It was another holding penalty. That penalty is declined, or a chop block, rather. Penalty declined, and that will take us to halftime. And with your score is the Dinwiddie Generals at 18, and the Evergreen Eagles at 6. Also, a quick announcement with Michael Beck. Please come to the CQL tent. Michael Beck, please come to the CQL tent. Thank you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's give a warm round of applause for the Dinwiddie Generals cheerleaders as they're set to perform their halftime routine.
Yeah, no, my bad. I'm going to
All right, let's give it up one more time for the Dinwiddie Generals cheerleaders. Great job out there, ladies. And the second half matchup between the Eagles and the Generals will resume in approximately 10 minutes.
CQL family, we have a couple of announcements that we want to make. First, we want to guys thank you guys for coming out in the cold to the senior game. Give your round, give yourselves a round of applause. Appreciate you. Give the players a round of applause. Just want to make an acknowledgement to our current commissioner, Mr. Tim Gallagher, has been in this role in the CQL leadership for over 7 years. And we just have a little presentation for him. So Kim, can you come to the
I think we should be able to distinguish them two pretty good, right?
And last but not least, we have Mr. Brian Tichy, who is the deputy commissioner, who has been in this role for over 7 years, well, on and off of different roles. We just want to say thank you both for your time, your commitment to CQL.
Thank you all very much. Really appreciate it. It was a pleasure to serve more than 7 years, voting rep before that, and this is what makes it all fun. Watching these kids develop, watching these kids grow, and just the competitive nature that's out here. Thank you all.
Hey, good afternoon, everyone. Thanks for coming out. I echo Tim's comments that he just made. I want to say, too, we're leaving in good, great hands with the board coming on behind us, and I really appreciate everything that people have done throughout the past 7 years. Thank you.
Thank you.
So we're set to begin the second half matchup between Evergreen and Dinwiddie. Dinwiddie currently leads 18-6. Sean Hicks here, providing you with live commentary for today's game. Whistles blown. Also, today's game is being recorded by RVA Sports Production. This game, along with previous games and later games, or games later on, will be recorded and posted on YouTube. So offside penalty called against the Generals. They'll back them up 5 yards. They'll re-kick from the 35. And second half is underway. And picked up at the 24 by Davis. And Davis to the outside, and that tackle is made. Nice special team play there by number 17, that's Rondell Golson. Penalty flag thrown on the field. And it's going to be a face mask penalty called against Dinwiddie. So it's first down and 10 for Evergreen, ball at the 35. Hewitt, screen pass, caught by Carter. Looked like a double pass, but it's improv. And a nice tackle there made at the line of scrimmage. Good tag team effort there by McDevlin Manson and Javion Hill Jackson. Second down and 10. Hewitt in the pocket. He's going to throw this one deep, and it is incomplete. Pass was a little bit underthrown there. Nice secondary play there by Parham. So that brings up third down and 10. Third down play. Oh, Hewitt bobbles it, and he's going to take off and going nowhere. And a good tackle there made by Gabriel Randall. As he's able to take advantage of the miscue there. Brings up fourth down and long for the Eagles. So Evergreen will line up to punt this one away. And this one is angled right toward the Dinwiddie sideline. Let's see where officials mark it at. It will be at the 47-yard line. All right, so we'll see the Generals offense for the first time this half. It'll be first down and 10, ball at their own 47. First down and 10. Handoff to Manson. Manson is dropped down right at midfield. And good tag team tackle there by Cameron Wasaki, along with number 14, that's Shaq Abdul-Razakov. So that brings up second down and let's call it 7. Handoff to Nelson, out the middle. Nelson runs a man over, he's got the first down for the Generals. Abdul-Razakov there on the stop for the Eagles. And the Generals in Eagles territory, just inside the 40-yard line. Handoff again, it goes to Nelson. And Nelson bounces it outside, throws a vicious stiff arm. Penalty flag thrown on the field. As Nelson jogs into the end zone, but this one will likely come back. So it's a personal foul face mask penalty called against Dinwiddie. So it'll be a 15-yard penalty, and we'll replay first down. All right, so the ball is spotted at midfield. So it's first down and long for the Generals. And penalty flags thrown on the field. Prior to the snap, offsides called against Evergreen. That's going to be a 5-yard penalty. And again, we'll replay first down. Toss play goes to Manson. And Manson is met by a sea of black jerseys on that play. Wasicki leads the charge. Also there on the stop was number 21. That's Sam Verberg. And it's going to be a keeper by Kayvon Wiggins. And Wiggins, so he pushes off two Eagles defenders, but then he is escorted out of bounds after a short pickup. So it brings up third down, and let's call it 16. All right, third down and long coming up for Dinwiddie. 4 minutes left in the third quarter. And Wiggins with the fake, and it's not fooling the Eagles defense that time. He's met by a whole bunch of Eagles. Leading the charge on that was number 25. That's Elijah Freeman. So that brings up fourth down and 14. Down and 14 coming up for Dinwiddie. Eagles looking to make a mandatory stop here. Wiggins in trouble. Wiggins sacked in the backfield right at midfield. And who else but the big Falsicky there on the stop. And that's going to be a turnover on downs. Evergreen back on offense at midfield. First and 10. First and 10 for the Eagles. Hewitt sets up the screen. Oh, he's got a lot of room right there. That's Anthony Carter. Ball hits the juke button. Hits it again. And then he is brought down by a bunch of generals. And the Eagles get the first down. Bill Jackson leads the charge with the tackle. So nice design there for Evergreen. New line of scrimmage at the Generals 32. First down and 10 as we are approaching the 2 minute mark. Evergreen trying to cut into the deficit here. Hands off to Russ, he bobbled it for a bit, and he's just storming through the Generals' defense. Rondrell Golson there on the tackle, and that's going to be good for another Evergreen first down. And Dinwiddie wisely calls a timeout. They're going to talk things over. That's their first charge timeout of the half. Resume play after the Evergreen first down. It's first and 10, ball at the 21. Handoff to Carter. Carter breaks a tackle. Ooh, he is brought down hard. And that was number 44. That's Jeremiah Curley coming in with the tackle. So that was a pickup of 5 yards. Brings up second and 5. Second down, Osaki, the ball carrier. And it's taken literally all the defenders from the Generals to get him down as he stands him up after a pickup of about 3 yards. Brings up third and 2. Thank you. Third down and two, 30 seconds left in the third. And Wasiki up the middle, charging forward, keeping the legs chopping, that's first and goal for the Eagles. As he just bullies his way through the Generals' defense on that play. Are going to run the clock out, and that will take us to the end of the third quarter, as the Generals still lead over the Eagles 18-6. So we start the fourth quarter. First down and goal for Evergreen. They try to score their second touchdown of the game. Hewitt throws it. He's got a man. It's broken up. Nearly intercepted there. Good job by Rondell Golson. Pass was intended for Rasheed Davis. Second down and goal. Wasiki up the middle, and a bunch of Generals jump in to bring him down. So it brings up third down and goal after a pickup of a yard. And the jump pass, they go back to it, and it's a touchdown! It worked earlier, and it works again. And good connection there from Wysocki to Robbie Chase. He gets his first touchdown of the game in the Evergreen. Cuts the deficit to 6, extra point coming up. All right, so Evergreen lines up for the 2-point conversion. Potentially cut this game into 4. Kick is up. Kick is no good. All right, so it's a 6-point game. Dinwiddie leads over Evergreen 18-12. Line up to kick it off. It is an onside kick. It goes off a Generals player. Ooh, and luckily for them, it goes out of bounds. So, Dinwiddie will start. back on offense, put it on the spot, will be. We'll be right at the 48-yard line. We'll be first down and 10 for the Generals. First and 10, ball on the Eagles, 48. Wiggins hands off to Nelson. Nelson throwing players off, but here comes the black jerseys coming to make the stop on the play. So nice job there by the Evergreen front line. No gain on the play, second and 10. Handoff to Manson. Manson wrestled down to the ground. Nice tackle there made by the big fella. That's number 73. That's Carter Warren. Brings up third down and 7. Third down and 7, handoff to Nelson, dropped in the backfield. It is Shane Griffin coming up with the stop. Brings up fourth down for Dinwiddie. Right, so Dinwiddie lines up to punt this one away. A high, but good punt there by Nelson. They'll take a friendly Generals roll. Right at the 17-yard line. All right, so Evergreen back on offense. They're down by 6 with 6:25 left in the fourth. Let's see what happens on this drive. First and 10. Down and 10, Wysocki, the carrier. Up the middle, and he's brought down. A bunch of Generals there on the stop, leading the charge, Miles Bracey. So not much of a gain on that play, second down. The result of this game will be the kick, run, and pass competition for both the North and the South. Anthony Carter, ball carrier, and he is brought down to the ground. Good tackle there. That was Austin Wells who made the initial tackle. Third down and 9. And a timeout is called on the field by Evergreen. That's their first charge timeout.
Thank you.
play, and it is third down and 9 for Evergreen. Drops back, it's the screen. That's been the bread and butter so far today. To go right back to it, it's Anthony Carter. An open field, and he runs out of bounds. That's first down for the Eagles. Nice throw there by Preston Hewitt, able to get it to Carter, and he took care of the rest. So, first down and 10, ball spotted at the 43. Hewitt hands off to Carter. And Carter, oh man, he took a shot there, and it is Miles Bracy once again. So, no gain on the play, second and 10. Hands off to Wysocki. He surges forward. He's tackled close to midfield. Again, a bunch of generals there on the stop. This brings up third down and 5. Wysocki, the ball carrier, he's in trouble, he's chucked in the backfield. Generals all over that play. Little Quinn Hawkins Jr. making the initial hit. That's a big time play for Dinwiddie. As that brings up fourth down and 11. And a timeout is called on the field by Evergreen. That's their second charge, timeout. Timeout, fourth down and 11. They need to get to the 46. Hewitt drops back to pass. He wants it all, throwing it deep, and it is broken up, incomplete. Good defensive secondary play there for the Generals. Is Jamin Perrin able to break that up? And that's going to be a turnover on downs. Dinwiddie takes over, first and 10. Down and 10. Handoff up the middle. That was Manson with the short pickup, and a timeout is called on the field by the Eagles. That's their third and final charge. Timeout. Open your eyes, look up to the skies. And Wiggins, after the low snap, is able to pick it up, run it for minimal yardage. So it brings up third down. Just under 2 minutes left in the fourth. Handoff to Nelson. And Nelson going nowhere. A bunch of Eagles on the stop. But the ball comes loose. And it is Evergreen football. Oh, how things have turned. And we got ourselves a situation here. It is first down and 10 for Evergreen. All right, so first and 10, Evergreen, they're out of timeouts. So they've got to hurry and hurry quick. So a touchdown here can tie it up. Hewitt drops back to pass. Throws a screen, it's caught by Carter. Carter in trouble, he's brought down. And once again, it's Miles Bracey. He's been coming up big this second half for Dinwiddie. Evergreen on timeout, they gotta go no huddle here. 30 seconds left. And Hewitt spikes the ball, stopping the clock at 26. Also, a quick announcement with Anthony Wilson and family. Please report to the end zone. Anthony Wilson and family, please report to the end zone. Thank you. So a big time play here. Things get intense. Third down and 11. Evergreen needs to get to the 49 of Dinwiddie to keep the drive going. Hewitt drops back to pass. He throws it deep. He's got a man. And it's off the hands of his intended receiver, Malachi Hill. Falls incomplete. Brings up fourth down and 11. Down and 11. Hewitt drops back to pass. Screen pass caught by Rasheed Davis. Davis to the outside. Davis, oh, he's brought down. If he's in bounds, the clock will keep running. Well, so it stops momentarily at 9.3. All right, and it starts again. So this will likely be the final play here for Evergreen. And they spike it, it stops the clock to 3.4. So the clock stops after the first down, under 2 minutes. On the first down, they spike the ball, stopping the clock, 3.4, second and 10. So Evergreen here, they're gonna have to get into the end zone on this play. Dinwiddie looking to make a Super Bowl defensive stand here. Back to pass. Hewitt in trouble. He's getting chased from behind and he throws it. It's caught by Dyson Coleman. Coleman to the outside. Coleman's got blockers. Dyson Coleman still on his feet. And he's going to be short. That was a great effort by Coleman, but he's going to be short. And with that, the Dinwiddie Generals win their first senior Super Bowl in association history from CQL. Oh, a nail biter that came to the very end, but Dinwiddie was able to prevail. And a heck of a game by both teams. And that will take us to our final score, with the Generals defeating the Eagles 18-12.